I would travel and show. My mama used to dance for the money they'd throw. Mama would do whatever he could. Preach a little gospel, sell a couple bottles of Dr. Good. Gypsies, tramps, and thieves, we'd hear it from the people of the town. They'd call us gypsies, tramps, and thieves. But every night all the men would come around and lay their money down. Up a boy just south of Mobile, gave him a ride, filled him with a hot meal. I was 16, he was 21. Rode with us to Memphis, and Papa would have shot him if he knew what he'd done. Gypsies, tramps, and thieves, we'd hear it from the people of the town. They'd call us gypsies, tramps, and thieves. But every night all the men would come around, lay their money down. Never had schooling, but it taught me well with its smooth southern style. 3 months later, I'm a gal in trouble, and I haven't seen him for a while. Oh, I haven't seen him for a while. Oh, she was born in the wagon of a traveling show.
Say, how come you never made it in talking pictures?
I don't know.
I know what you're thinking. Did he fire 6 shots or only 5?
Please don't squeeze the shine.
TV viewers get the first sustained look in living color of Earthmen on the moon, some 238,000 miles away. Apollo 14 gets off to a shaky start, but in the end, Alan Shepard, Edgar Mitchell, and Stuart Roosa make it all work.
Ali and Frazier, Muhammad Ali. I call him Muhammad Ali because that's what he wants. Oh, yeah, he's a big dude and he hits hard, you know. I'll call him what he wants. But it's good that he's being allowed to work again. As you know, he couldn't work for 3 years. Of course, he had a strange job beating people up. But that was his, you know, his right. He could have that job. Government wanted him to change jobs. Government wanted him to kill people. He thought it over and he said, no, that's where I draw the line. I'll beat him up and I don't want to kill him. And the government told him, well, if you won't kill him, we won't let you beat him up.
What's my name?
Popeye Doyle. If he doesn't like you, he'll take you apart.
Hold it!
The French Connection.
Yeah. Clarice, laying down your mind.
He tries to center comes to Frederick. He'll shoot. Save and rebound. Covered up in front by Dryden. And a good wrist shot by Friedrich is...
Fastball, call strike three.
The pitch to Freehand. Here's a long drive, way back. Maybe it is. It's gone. Bill Freehand. Tigers lead 3-0.
Here it is. Ball four. That'll score the tying run. Here. The count is 1-0. The pitch. Fastball. There she goes. It might be a big one. It's going. It's falling short, but that gets the run home. And the Tigers, in a tremendous come-from-behind victory here this afternoon, beat Oakland 4-3. And this series is tied at 2 games each. Holy cow!
God'll get you for that one.
The Black Avenger. Blackula.
Nixon wins re-election in a landslide victory and immediately looks to the future.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. Into the dirt! Here comes the
corner when he runs. Alone again. Naturally.
Our worst fears have been realized tonight. They have now said that there were 11 hostages.
Responding to a special invitation, President and Mrs. Nixon arrive, and Premier Joe Enlai is on hand to extend an official welcome to the presidential couple. Wallace survives, but his wounds leave him a paralyzed man.
I can't believe we've won the whole thing.
The Truman Library in Independence, Missouri, where the body of former Chief Executive Harry S. Truman lies in state. The Nixon-Agnew team receives an overwhelming mandate from the American voters, sweeping every state but one, Massachusetts. The Apollo phase of the United States space exploration program concludes in a blaze of glory.
Oh, offer can't refuse.
A short time ago, an American airplane dropped one bomb on Hiroshima and destroyed its usefulness to the enemy.
Robinson dashes to the plate. It's close, and umpire Summers calls him safe on the daring maneuver. But Yogi Berra doesn't think so.
Hits him one day. 3-1 to him. It's a high fly into deep right center. Minnesota's way back. That one's going, and it is gone.
Why do you want to get mixed up with somebody like that?
When you're as big as Arnie and me, Paul, there's some things he's got to learn, Paul, some things that I learned.
And all you pitchers remember the new league ruling. Anyone using grease on their hair for the purpose of throwing a grease ball will be thrown out of the game.
Meanwhile, back in the year one, when you belonged to no one, you didn't stand a chance, son, if your pants were undone, 'cause you were bred for humanity and sold to society. One day you'll wake up in the present day, a million generations removed from expectations of being who you really want to be. Skating away, skating away, skating away on the thin ice of a new day.
Don't you see? The crisis is over.
What crisis?
Black people have arrived. They're here. I ain't letting them in.
She reads all the press releases about what I plan to do to her. She will be out of her mind.
My baloney has a first name.
Say, what does sangria mean?
It means blood.
I'm telling you that that thing upstairs isn't my daughter.
If I don't see a ribbon around the old, old tree.
And a fight breaks out. Pete Rose and Buddy Harrelson. Both clubs spill out of the dugouts.
That was, and that is, the simple truth.
The agreement on ending the war and restoring peace in Vietnam was initialed by Dr. Henry Kissinger on behalf of the United States.
I don't think there'll be ever anything to celebrate.
I think it's a war that we've never got involved in.
I'm not a politician, I'm an actress.
But at first, almost everyone thought, no gasoline, impossible.
And I think within 10 years, 75% of the cars on the road will be steam cars.
I had no prior knowledge of the Watergate break-in.
I thought you walked tall. Look like you didn't learn how to crawl.
Walking Tall. The story of a real man. They beat him. They cut him. But they couldn't shut him up.
You let them do this to me and get away with it, and you give them your turn right to do the same damn thing to any one of you.
Or hold him down. Walking Tall.
Eastwood is back in full force as Dirty Harry in Magnum Force.
The way we were.
Called again. That's a 2-minute penalty to them. This time Boston gets it. Hadney can't get it out. Clayton, a low drive. Let's save Gilbert. Super stop by Gilbert. These goalies have been brilliant. Philadelphia haven't had that many shots, but they've had about four of them. They've had five shots in this game, and four of them have really tested Gilbert. We'll see it again. Here he is with that glove hand. Followed it all the way. You talk about reflexes. Both of these goaltenders have them. 1:14 left in O'Reilly's penalty. Still lots of time for the Flyers here. Scoreless hockey. Power play opportunity. 5 men against 4. Face off to the left of Gilbert. Same people on the ice. McLeish against Shepard. McLeish controls to DuPont. DuPont throws it and scores! McLeish cuts that. He got his second goal of this series. And he lengthens his lead in the playoffs. And the Flyers have been winning all those big faceoffs. Nothing the Flyers lead. If they hold it, they will win the Stanley Cup. Perron holds it up for Van Imp. Van Imp up the boards for McLeish. Badnay comes in to try and keep it in. It's knocked out again. 16 seconds left. Barber after a loose puck.
15 seconds left in the game. Joseph down the ice.
Thank you.
for the man.
Too much for the man. He couldn't make it.
So he's leaving the life he's come to know. Ooh.
He said he's going.
He said he's going back to find.
Going back to find.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. What's left of his world? The world he left behind.
Now Calvin tries to clear. Can't. Comes to Mags in front. Backhand score! Steve Mags, number 11 on the season. A backhand shot in front. And it's 2-2. Centering pass. Sutherland. Nelson in front. They poke at it. Sutherland can score! Center's fielder score! A beautiful pass. He's got a 3-on-1. Only gaining back. Lenahan right in. Shoots. Score! Boosin front and Blessin makes the save. A brilliant save by Blessin to keep the shutout alive.
Super two.
I'm Ewell Gibbons. Many consider me an expert on natural foods like cattails.
There's something about Aqua Velva.
He wants to be cool and refreshed.
Hold the pickle, hold the lettuce. Special orders don't upset us. All we ask is that you let us serve it your way.
Look for the real thing. Let's hope the car alive. It's the real thing.
You know the guy's names on the baseball team?
Yes.
Well, go ahead. Who's on first?
Yes.
I mean the guy's name.
Who?
The guy playing first.
Who?
The guy playing first base.
Who?
The guy on first base.
Who is on first?
What are you asking me for? I don't know.
This gift is from Jackie O'Golly O'Shucks. I hope that you like it. It costs $40.
You're going to twice be entertained by them. Right now and again in the second half of our show. Ladies and gentlemen, the Beatles. That's...
Dirty, 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 another dirty person.
You have a dirty rifle, dirty person, you know that?
But, sir, I...
Get it clean!
Yes, sir.
Look off that smile. Tighten up that face. I want to see them lips white. I want to see them tight. Get a mean look on your face, boy. Mean!
I don't wear pantyhose, but a beauty mist can make my legs look good. Imagine what they'll do for yours.
I know it was you, Fredo.
Because what you see here is, kid, a dynamite!
And someone, quite likely...
We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in.
People have got to know whether or not their president is a crook. Well, I'm not a crook.
I shall resign the presidency effective at noon tomorrow. Vice President Ford will be sworn in as president at that hour in this office.
I mean, he had to resign because he lied about the cover-up.
He did not lie. He forgot to tell the truth.
There's been a big kidnapping on the West Coast. The victim is Patricia Hearst, the daughter of newspaper executive Randolph Hearst and a granddaughter of the legendary William Randolph Hearst.
The Hibernia Bank Sunset Branch was held up at gunpoint this morning at 9:40. In addition, Patricia Campbell Hearst has been named in a federal warrant, charging her with being a material witness to the bank robbery.
In Boston, where America's public school system was born, an order to bus blacks into white schools and whites into black schools brings defiance of the law.
He's just in the mood to ride in the new.
Well, yes, they call him the street.
Boogie there, boogie there.
He likes to turn the other cheek.
Boogie there, boogie there.
He's always making the news. Wearing just his tennis shoes. Guess you could call him unique.
probably the only laugh that man will ever get in his life is by stripping off and showing his shortcomings.
Joshua represents the Dodgers' last chance. Raleigh Fingers wraps it up, and the Oakland Coliseum explodes into ecstasy as the Oakland A's capture their third successive world championship.
Jim, all I can tell you is happy landings, Evel Knievel. I don't know what to say. I've never seen anything like this. 3, 2, 1. Whoa, it looks like a good one. Whoa. Oh, Evel, stay with the bird. He looks like he's... Whoa, there's been a mistake. He looks like he's going into the canyon. The ship's going down.
Let's play a warm-up three-man
hand.
Deal him up.
Well, where are the cards?
Bye. You ready to go? You fired up?
Oh, yeah. I get up for each contest. I have to survive.
Huh?
Always enjoy a hockey game.
Oh, yeah.
Always a pleasure to be in one.
All right,
Gordy Campbell. Snake's getting fired up. He was in the other room vomiting a minute ago. He had a bucket with it. Snake, he was in vomiting. Yeah, he's right.
Life, so they say, is but a game and they let it slip away. Love, like the autumn sun, should be dying, but it's only just begun. Like the twilight in the road up ahead, they don't see just where we're going. And all the secrets in the universe whisper in our ears. Say, for the fools, and they let them drift away. Peace, like the silent dove, should be flying, but it's only just begun. Like Columbus in the olden days, we must gather all our courage. Sail our ships out on the open sea. Cast away our fears, and all the years will come and go. Take us up, always up. We may never pass this way again. We may never pass this way again. We may never pass this way again. So laugh while the laughing is easy. I wanna cry, and it made it worthwhile. I may never pass this way again. That's why I want it with you. 'Cause you make me feel like I'm more than a friend. Like I'm the journey, the journey's in.
Thank you.
a moon gets a big and bright. It's supernatural delight. Every border was dancing in the moonlight. Everybody here is out of sight.
cast a little light on someone. It's not too soon. You took me halfway around the world.
Welcome back.
Saigon. The peace agreement signed in early 1973 didn't end the war.
You're gonna need a bigger boat.
Anti-busing groups had worked for a year building momentum for their side, and so despite a massive presence of police in riot gear, South Boston broke out in violence on September 8th.
My father, James R. Hoffa, has been missing for some 32 hours.
Shortly after noon, on April 30th, 1975, the flag of the Provisional Revolutionary Government is raised at the Presidential Palace, a signal that a century of Western influence in Vietnam is dead. New York needs $500 million a month to keep its head above water. The city is forced to take a hard look at itself. So New York asks the feds to bail it out. Gerald Ford's reaction? A very firm no. Not until the city first does something to help itself. Reverend Ike.
I say there is no virtue in poverty. There is no honor in poverty. Money loves me.
His six homes and 26 cars are mere tokens in evidence.
Television's grown up now. No one needs a marriage vow. Folks go to the toilet now.
Propose to Bill.
Come and say prune juice and tush and party out loud.
We can show my pregnancy.
And John Boy can have BD. Plus a quick vasectomy.
After 9 o'clock.
Good evening. In California today, President Ford looked down the barrel of a loaded automatic held by a red-haired woman in a long red dress. But the gun didn't go off, and he's all right. The woman was wrestled to the ground by a Secret Service man, and the president was hustled away. She is being charged with attempted murder of the president. She is 26-year-old Lynette Alice Fromm, nicknamed Squeaky. She's a member of the so-called Manson family, followers of the convicted murderer, Charles Manson.
Most people think I'm a real monster, but actually I'm quite sensitive. That's why I drink light beer from Miller. Tastes great, but what I really like is it's less filling. And light's got one-third less calories than your regular beer. I can't afford to get filled up. I'm too sensitive.
Okay, Mr. Sensitive, you're up.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
But I cheat the hangman.
Cheated him many times before.
Then I toss the armor. Turns sweet lips to sour. Yes, I cheat the hangman.
And even when life has flown away,
I kiss the hangman.
Cheated
that fell upon my stone. Like tears of pride I shed alone. I walk the night, I cannot sleep. The love you spend, you cannot leave. But I...
I may be late, but I came down here. I go, that's great. That's just great.
There's a great movie on this afternoon. The Longest Day.
I watched The Deadly Bees. Who was it? Dawson's Greatest Throw.
What?
You ever heard of that? I read the book The Longest Day. It's about a guy named Dawson that chucked this.
No, Robert, this is about D-Day.
I know, but this guy, it's during D-Day, a guy named Dawson.
My brother, if you could cast a little light on someone, it's not too soon. You took me halfway around the world. I'm running out of time and reason.
And our PR man, Ben Hudson, informs us the paid attendance tonight, 125 strong. Now Dave Bell will look to feed it ahead to Connor. He can't control. Now it comes to Sutherland. Oh, Suds goes in 3-on-2. He splits the defense. Moving right in. Backhand shot. Save. Knockdown in front as Sutherland came awful close to goal number 4. Dave Bell back with it now at the red line. He skates it in. Goes right around a man. 3-on-2. Feeds Bilner. Bilner moving in. Back to Bell. Score. Dave Bell on a feed from Bobby Bilner. And it's now a 4-0 game. Time of the goal comes at 9 minutes, 40 seconds. We'll wait for the announcement.
I gave a girl a ride in the wagon. She crawled in and took control.
I was lucky to get rid of that queen.
2.
1, 2.
3, 16.
8.
We got 2?
I did. Really good.
I knew. Lou, you're starting off exactly the way you started.
No, last time I had 13.
I mean, no, I mean, you're starting off bad. 11 bucks.
I read the Bible.
No,
well,
you're not supposed to.
Bucks, I've never won in one of the hearts game.
That's why
I'm going to have it.
You gave it to me.
I combed my hair today. My God.
Captain Fantastic, raised and regimented, hardly a hero. Just someone his mother might know. Very clearly a case for cornflakes and classics. 2 teas, both with sugar, please. In the back of an alley. While little dirt cowboys
turn brown in their saddles. Sweet chocolate biscuits and red
roses.
A little harder to scare some guys.
You're just another pretty face in the crowd anyway.
I know.
Yeah, we thought you'd be playing for Cleveland Barons.
They're called the Crusaders now.
That's why we thought you'd be with the Barons.
They pulled it.
So did Minnesota today, I understand.
They pulled it, the Saints?
Yeah.
It is great. Can't wait for that whole league falls. They're going to have a big party.
Well, yeah, the whole league falls. I hope they move the team into Cleveland. I don't have to.
First goal is for number 8, Steve Neal. Assistant number 17, Bob Gorse. And number 5, Dave Bingham. Time of the goal, 16 minutes, 29 seconds. Beatles score for the charter with an assist to Boris and Bingham.
July 4th, 1976, after 200 years, the nation took a day off to celebrate its achievements.
Meow, 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 meow.
Look at that, right to the handstand. Gorgeous.
My daddy always says I was really good at parlor games.
Mel, would you like to do something for me?
Yeah, what?
Kiss my grits!
And if I could just move Carter's army to Massachusetts and to Florida, yeah! I don't think anybody can beat us.
I'm Garson Kanin. 200 years ago today, a 50-year-old Virginia planter and scholar delivered the document that Virginia's convention had asked him to write.
Good morning. We're here, and we'll be here throughout the day in this red, white, and blue studio to take a look at what the second oldest major continuing nation in the world is doing to celebrate the 200th anniversary of its independence.
What a sight for my eyes to see you in sleep. Could it stop the sunrise, hearing you weep? You're not seen, you're not heard, but I stand by my word.
Charter's goal is second of the evening, scoreman number 16, Craig Connor. Charter's goal, scoreman number 19, Dave Brent. Charter's goal for the hat trick, scored by number 2, Dave Fell. Assist to number 8, Steve Vino. And number 9, Steve Maggs.
A change in goal for the Chargers, number 30, Mark Smith, replaces number 33, Chuck Russell.
Defense,
three
line, three defensemen.
Three goalies.
We got 18 goal lines. We played 2 goalies
at once, Stanley. Hey, any body checks? 5 minutes.
Yeah, to end your belt.
More than I could feel. Touching. What is real? Oh, my mind is reeling round. Caroline is feeling down today. Falling in and out of love. thinking just the other day, something that would ease her mind, something that I meant to say to her.
He's a truthful president. He's a down-to-earth type of person. And I think he has the best qualifications to stay in the White House.
He's my kind of president.
President Ford is your president. Keep him.
I'll never tell a lie. I'll never make a misleading statement. I'll never betray the confidence that any of you has in me. And I will never avoid a controversial issue.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
Listen, I have a friend who loves what you do every year and who just wanted to come out. Would you send my friend out, please? Okay, where is he? Will you send him out here? Come here.
America is the land of opportunity.
Yeah.
Thank you.
President's Men, the story of the two young reporters who cracked the Watergate conspiracy.
White House.
Howard Hunt, please.
This whole thing is a cover-up. It's right on our nose.
And piece by piece, they solve the greatest detective story in American history.
That Carter family from Plains, Georgia, were the first farmers to become the first family since Andrew Jackson grew cotton and tobacco.
See? I just can't believe he's dead. But I just thank God that Elvis died here in Graceland.
That the police have captured a man whom they believe to be the son of Sam.
He's a pepper, she's a pepper, we're a pepper. Wouldn't you like to be a pepper too?
Reggie Jackson. Long drive right field, it is.
Goodbye.
When lightning strikes in 1977, New York is paralyzed. No lights.
There is some sporadic looting in Queens, Manhattan.
More than 2,000 stores are looted. An estimated $1 billion in property losses.
You know, it takes a lot to upset an easy-going guy like me. But tonight, I have meatballs. And they're laying here like hardballs. And the fettuccine feels like it'll be here next season. It's enough to give a guy an upset stomach.
Upset stomach, Pepto-Bismol. It coats, soothes, relieves.
Hey, I think I'll try a swig of this.
Billy, will you use a spoon?
Oh, no!
Now, listen to the foam side. Then listen to the edge side.
Everything tastes great when it sits on a Ritz.
It's not too sweet. It's a cool, refreshing treat.
So for a snack, with the great flavor of cheese.
After all, isn't color the way to choose an instant camera?
I'm Jimmy the Greek, and if you're shaving with Edge, you're a winner.
Weekends were made for Michelob.
Come on, come on, come on, and taste the fancy way.
What's that supposed to mean?
Basurero, it means junkyard.
Get out of here. Take your flies with you.
What flies?
Your flies. You people got flies all around you. And while you're standing here, your flies are getting together with my flies and making more flies.
I want you to get up right now and go to the window, open it, and stick your head out and yell, I'm as mad as hell, and I'm not going to take this anymore!
See-ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. Our finest gifts we bring, ba-rum-ba-bum-bum, rum-ba-bum-bum, rum-ba-bum-bum.
Thank you.
You look good there, boys, I can tell you.
Not as good as you, Max.
No, I don't know.
If you hadn't had the camera on him, he would have made that birdie putt.
Yeah.
That's right.
You guys look good on that tee.
Yeah, that's about the only
that
place.
Sounds like
I just want you on the camera.
Yes, Dan, thank you very much. We're just happy to be here.
Say hi to my mother, will you?
Hi, Mom.
She always asks about you.
Hi, Mom.
Hi. Hi, bye. How are you?
Oh, good. Bob Bart, here we go.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the former Texas Sports Arena for the 25th anniversary Hillsdale Hockey Alumni Game. Let's meet the coaching staff, starting with the founder of Hillsdale Hockey in the late 1960s, Jim Bobridge.
Yeah.
The former coach, the former player, he was effectively known as the old man. In 1974, this forward Detroit Red Wings Hall of Famer took over the reins to literally save the program following the departure of Jim Bobridge. Ted Lindsay!
Yeah!
And that is starting with us. O'Leary!
Come on, Steve. Oh. No, we got it.